Right, we're back, and I completely forgot what we were doing, and I got absorbed in something else, and food took longer than I anticipated, since I have no food, so I just had some fucking vindaloo. Had to cook that bitch, though. What was I doing? I completely forgot what we were doing. There you go. Handy guide thing. That's all, should we with the doctor? No, let's see, we go take again. We don't have it, we came all the way with this. So, even if I leave empty handed, at least I got to sit. Come on, man. Alright, I think. I swear that was from fucking ages ago, but okay. So, are we going back there? Yes, we are.
Alright, I gotta remember why, for what, but. Oh, wait, we're getting his passport, that was it. Oh, it's you again. Looking for Mr. Wright? He was just here a second ago. Oh, wow, that's inconvenient. He was? What was Daddy doing here? Good question. He said he was looking for something. Did he say anything else? Let me think. Something about how his ride never showed up at the airport. Yes, that was it. I guess Athena really did get lost. But what's Daddy doing all the way out here in the first place? He can't be looking for us since no one told him we'd be here. Well, if you're here to take another look around, be my guest. I have other work to do, so if you'll excuse me. Of course. Thanks, Emma. Righty-ho, then. First and foremost, we'd better find Dats's passport. We should also have a word with Dr. Buff's child. Oh, yeah. Forgot about that one. Hey, is it just me, or is there something new in here? Oh, you mean that thing? Yeah, we should take a closer look at it too. Let's not forget about Dats's passport. It should be around here somewhere.
Somewhere? Would it not be in his fucking briefcase?
Right, what is that? What's this? A model helicopter? Don't you know anything, Apollo? It's a drone! They're all the rage right now! I bet it belongs to the Doctor's kid! We need to ask them about the orb's whereabouts. Them. Yeah, but luring out a shut-in isn't going to be easy.
Thanks for that. I'm not... yeah. Okay.
Yeah, I thought so. Check his fucking briefcase again. That's his suitcase. Maybe his passport's in there. Maybe! Arrgh, it's no good. It's locked tight. We should have asked him for the key.
Oh, hang on.
Oh. What are we going to do about Dats's passport? It's probably right there inside his suitcase, but we can't get it open. Why don't you take it down the fucking police station, you pillocks? Why don't I take it over to Dats so he can unlock it? That way, you guys can continue looking for the orb. Good thinking, Trucy. Okay, here I go! Huh? What the? This thing weighs a ton! Let me try. Jeez, how can a suitcase be so heavy? Is it filled with bricks or something? Oh dear. Knowing Dats, he probably packed his dumbbells in there. It's certainly much too heavy to lug all the way to the detention center. Here, let me take a crack at that lock. What? Are you gonna pick it? Click, 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 click! There you go. That was fast. Ha! 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 A lock like that is child's play to me! Especially after all the wrongly imprisoned compatriots I've busted out over the years. You've sure seen a lot of action for an ex-lawyer. And here we go. Dats's passport. I'll take it over to him. Thanks, Trucy. No problem. Now you guys enjoy some quality father-son treasure hunting time, okay? See you later. There she goes. I wish she wouldn't make such a big deal out of our little family situation. Father-son time, eh? Been ages since we've had a father-son talk, huh, son? Yeah, well, over a decade. So, Apollo, how have you been? Oh, fine. I'm fine, I guess. Is that so? Fine, you say? Well, fine is fine by me. Good to hear. Okay. I like Dirk, he's cool. So what do we talk about now? Hmm? Get down! Hit the dirt, son! Huh? Oh, crikey. What the? Ah! Ah, that seems a bit excessive. Oof. Oh dear. Well, Apollo's dead. Speak to me, son! Say something! Oh, that's smart. Oh yeah, bullets will do that to you. You maggots! What do you think you're doing invading buff airspace? It'll be a scorching day in Siberia before you get past me, you yellow-bellied yahoos. Whoa! It can talk! What kind of drone is this Sorry, it wasn't an R, it was an I. Drone nothing, that's Sergeant Buff to you, soldier. You got that, you lowly grunts? Ow. What the who now? Buff? Sounds like the doctor's son is behind the controls. He's controlling this thing? Apollo, let's play along for now. At least until we can get the information we need out of him. Got it. Sergeant Buff? Sergeant Buff, sir! You forgot to say sir! Ain't you never seen a war movie before? Oh, right. Let me try that again. Sergeant Buff, sir! Better. Much better. Now, state your name, unit, and rank, soldier! Oh, I'm Apollo Justice. I serve at the Right Anything Agency, and my rank is, fledgling lawyer? Sir! Affirmative, Private Justice. Private? Listen up, diaper baby. Your commanding officer's orders are absolute. Disobedience means a one-way trip to the firing squad. Do I make myself clear? Oh, sir, yes, sir! Good, good. We might make a man out of you yet, Private. Now for you, Cyclops! Huh? Oh, you want my name, unit, and rank two? I'm Dirk Sardmardi. I command the rebel group, the Defiant Dragons, and my rank is, leader, sir. Excellent! Welcome aboard, Commander Dirk. Wait a second, what's with that ridiculous mop you call a head? Soldiers should be clean cut! Sorry, but this is my signature look. I'm not going to... Whoa! Fine, fine, I'll get a haircut before we ship out. Listen up, you. It's kill or be killed out on that battlefield. No place for leaving conditioners. All you've got is your life, and you're lucky to have that. He's oddly obsessed with field survival for someone who never goes outdoors. This is going to be harder than I thought, son. Right, well, this is different. Talking to a drone with a minigun that shoots something. Are you controlling that drone from your room, sir? Affirmative. But I can see everything you do from here, so... Ten hut, soldier! Wipe that stupid look off your face! I'm gonna whip you sheltered peacenecks into shape! With what, your charming personality? Look, it's got a camera and speakers too. Well, yeah, I think we gathered that. And that's not all, Commander! With these arms, I can cook and clean too. Speaking of which... Private Justice, you're on latrine duty. Snap to it on the double. Sigh. As if I don't see another the toilet back at the office. Oh, cool. That thing's pretty handy. Us Defiant Dragons could use one of those. Ha 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 ha! Yes, it is a fine piece of hardware, isn't it? I modified it especially for siege defense. Siege defense? You mean how you won't leave your room? Ah! Holding up in a stronghold to defend against an enemy is an age-old military tactic that never worked, really. A timeless strategy still applicable in modern warfare. No, not really, because, you know, bombs and shit. I hope you're not trying to mock the wisdom of my forefathers. I meant no offense. It was just an observation. So the greenhorn who ain't even discharged a firearm's got something to say, does he? Said, sorry, it won't happen again, sir. Darn tootin'. Now, state your intention, soldier. We had an agreement with your father. He had promised to hand over the Founder's Orb to us. What? Papa promised you that? He did, but he died before he could tell us where it's hidden. Now we have no idea where it is. Oh. Sniffle. Aww. The drone's sad! How can you do that to the drone? But Papa, why? Why do you have to die? Oh. It was an unfortunate accident, and I'm sorry for your loss. If it helps at all, I know how you feel, Sergeant. Ah! What do I do now? You insignificant maggot! What would an unseasoned rookie like you know about how I feel? First I lost Mama, and now I've lost Papa! You lost your mother too? She's been gone for some time now. I'm all alone now. All alone. Sniffle. Sergeant Buff, would you tell us a little more about what happened to your mother? What's his mother got to do with anything? Although, I suppose if he's sad. Maybe I'll hear him out. Mama passed away about 6 months ago. We were still living in our apartment in the city. Back then, I had yet to engage my siege defense strategy. In other words, something caused him to withdraw from the world. Yes, I wonder what. It was arson. It happened so suddenly, and before we knew it, our apartment was a sea of flames. Mama and I were trapped inside. But help never came. So Mama cradled me in her arms, kicked out a window, and jumped. She did what? She was like a walking, talking Medal of Valor, my Mama was. She delivered me safely to Terra Firma with a perfectly executed PLF. It's a 5-point landing technique used by paratroopers to land safely on the ground. She sounds like a superhero or something. But from that height, she suffered massive injuries in order to protect me. She died so that I could live! Ah! Mama! I don't know what to say. And the person who started the fire? He was immediately apprehended. They say he was standing outside laughing while the building burned. At least justice was served. I hope that brought you some solace. I've lost both my parents now. You can't possibly know how I feel! Sniffle. Sob. Mama. Papa. Poor kid. It's hard losing both your parents at such a young age. You must really feel alone now. Apollo. I imagine you know what he's going through. I do? The road to recovery begins by talking to someone who suffered the same hardship. I know you have something that shows you understand. Oh, right, okay. That's fucking... I've got to fucking present evidence that my dad is dead. Sergeant, sir, would you please take a look at this? What do we have here? It's a photo of my father. I wasn't even a year old when he died, in a fire. What?! And like your mother, he died in an arsonist blaze. But in his final moments, he managed to save his infant son. But Private Justice, you've suffered a loss just like mine? I have, and that's why I know how you feel. But, you still have your mother, don't you? No, I lost her too. What?! She disappeared after the fire. I don't know if she's still alive or dead. Heck, I don't even know what she looks like. Wow. Sergeant Buff, his experience is very much like your own. If anyone can understand the sadness in your heart, it's him. Compared to like being less than a year old when you don't know shit and the most productive thing you can do is cack yourself, compared to, I don't know how old Buff is, but like if it was just 6 months ago, I'm fairly certain that Apollo can't quite grasp the complexities of how he feels, but... Oh. Attention! I salute you, Comrade Justice. You are no longer a private in the Buff Army. Henceforth, you will be a corporal. Corporal? Congratulations on your promotion, Corporal Justice. I'm just glad that seemed to cheer him up a bit. Now, comrade, let's toast your new stripes. And call me Sarge. Don't be shy. We're a band of brothers now. Ha 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 ha. Now's our chance, Corporal. Ask him about the Founder's Orb. Dose getting way too much of a kick out of this.
I kind of like this game. It's pretty cool.
Are we actually going to see him, or is the drone it? Sarge, sir, do you have any idea where the orb might be? It was here in Papa's study until last night, but he said he was going to go hide it somewhere. He mentioned something about a shady character being after it. Where do you think he could have hidden it? Somewhere in the village, I'd guess. He said he found a suitable hiding place for it. So, it was here last night. That is, until he went out to hide it somewhere in the village. The only question is where? Maybe he left some clue here in his study. Let's search the place again. Brilliant. We should also find out more about Dr. Buff. It might steer us toward the hiding place. Can do! So, Sarge, what was your father like? Papa was as kind as Mama was courageous. His whole reason for moving to the countryside was for me. What do you mean? I initiated my siege defense strategy after Mama died. Papa was so worried about me, he moved us here to the countryside. He thought the fresh air, blue skies, and natural surroundings might alter my tactics. What a fine father. He even quit his position at the university to move here. He did. He did. He gave up his beloved research position just for me. A parent must be prepared to sacrifice everything for his child. That's what Papa said. Well, I'm feeling about 2 inches tall right about now. Yeah, you look like a bit of a twat there, Dirk. There's no one in the world I respected more than him. But that just makes his passing all the more devastating. Sniffle, sniffle. Papa, may you continue your beloved research up there with the angels.
Okay, well, we gotta fucking examine shit again.
Sarge, sir, do you ever read these books? Why, of course. Soldiers must have extensive knowledge as well as fighting prowess. I'm learning all I can each and every day in preparation for the big battle. The big battle? You know, for when I go back to school, I'll need to be up to date on every subject. Stuff like, you know, the latest comics and Hollywood gossip. Oh, I see. What about reading, writing, and arithmetic? Nah, I don't need that shit. Well, I'm rooting for you, Sarge. Thanks, I'll try my best.
So, hey, we gotta fucking look at all this shit again with him.
Oh, bollocks. Can we get into the computer? That might help. This computer could provide some useful information. Drat, it's password protected. Yes, we've been here and done that. Doug, you're good at getting into places you're not supposed to. Don't look at me, I don't know the first thing about computers. Ha 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 ha! Leave it to me! A modern day warrior must be well versed in technology and have mean, mean pride! After all, he who controls information controls the battlefield. Click, clack, click, clack, click, clack. Hooray! And I'm in! Looks like modern day warriors have mean, mean keyboard skills too. Okay, let's see what we can find. Click, clack, click, clack, click, clack. Clickety, clack, clack. Oh, what's this? An email message. Now this is interesting. It's a research report to whoever asked the doctor to study the orb. Here! I put the data on this! Take it and use it well, soldier! Lovely jubbly. Right. What is this? Exterminate! Exterminate! Destroy all humans! What's this thing's problem? It's an oop art, an out-of-place artifact. Papa won it in an online auction. An online auction? Yes, he said it's an alien weapon that destroyed an entire ancient civilization. Where do I even start with an explanation like that? Right, that it for this shite. Oh no, we got a bit more. It's a raincoat. Hmm? It's a bit wet and there's fresh mud on it. That must mean someone wore it recently. Indeed, maybe even as recently as last night, man, when he went out and buried the fucking orb. Sarge, did it rain here last night? Negative. There wasn't a cloud in the sky. Hmm, then how did this raincoat get all muddy and wet? When I saw it last evening, it looked pretty clean and dry to me. That means it got like this later at night. Good eye, son. This may very well turn out to be a vital clue. It's a shoe cubby. Hmm, these shoes look like they belong to Sarge and his dad. Ah, these boots here are a little damp. And it looks like there's something inside this one. Maybe Dr. Buff wore them last night. They might lead us to where he hid the orb. Let's take a closer look.
Inside of it, did he say? For fuck's sake, man, come on.
Something's giving off a soft glow inside this boot. But it's too dark in there to see what it is.
Well, what the fucking...
We might get a better look inside if we undid these straps. Thank you. Fuck's sake, now I've got to fucking find it again. There we go. It looks like some kind of glowing moss. It could have come from wherever the doctor went last night. Must have gotten in with some of that mud. It might be worth looking into, if it'll help us pinpoint where the doctor hid the orb. Oh. Fan Dabby Dozy.
That can't be it, can it? Come on, let's be honest, there's gonna be more shit.
There's always more shit!
Why are we looking at the briefcase? Okay, we'll look at the briefcase again!
Or suitcase, whatever, fuck you. It's Daz's suitcase. It's full of survival gear and questionable souvenirs. But we already got his passport, so we can leave it be for now. So why was it an object that I could look at, you dithering anuses? Alright. Okay, let's just go up there then. Is your room upstairs, Sarge? Yes, it's the one at the end of the hall. What do you say you come out so we can enjoy a snack together? But I promise we won't bite. If you insist. Then I'm not gonna talk to you anymore! No, wait! Dirk, you'd better apologize quick. I'm sorry for pushing. But very well, as long as you don't do it again, I'll let it slide this one time.
Okay, so what's the deal? Is there any more? I think that we got all of it, didn't we? I'd like to believe so, anyway. Oh, hang on.
Are these the doctors? Yes, those are Papa's reading glasses. He said he'd been having trouble reading lately. But those glasses seem to help. Reading glasses, eh? I'll just hold on to these. Dirk, don't tell me you're having trouble reading too. Perish the thought! I just don't want to leave any stone unturned! Okay, let's go over what we've learned so far. Wherever it was that Dr. Buff went, he needed a raincoat. And it was somewhere where this glowing moss grows. Any ideas where that might be, Sarge? Negative, comrade. I hate to say my intel's a little thin on this one. I've been occupied with my siege defense strategy ever since we moved to the village. Well, son, it seems we have no other choice. We'll have to ask the locals if they know any of a place like that.
Okie dokie, Batman.
Away! We're not gonna come up against Prickface again, are we? Ugh. Feels like somebody's watching me, and it's really creeping me out. Oh, it's just politicians' campaign posters. When did he put these up? Whatever, I've got more important things to be paying attention to. What great weather! It really lifts the spirits! I know, after our little treasure hunt, what do you say we go hunting, son? Hunting? We used to do that a lot, didn't we? Just look at that mountain! I bet there are some feisty wild boars up there! I think I'll pass, but thanks. Oh, so hunting's a no-go. Well, I guess that wild boar stew will have to wait then. Hmm? Apollo, something seems different from the last time we were here. It does. You mean the posters? No, not those. What's he talking about? Guess I should take a look around myself. There's a big boulder towering into the sky over there. According to the sign, it's called the Kurain Boulder. What an imaginative name. It also says that a spirit dwells within it. A rock with a spirit in it. It's called animism, the belief that spirits dwell within inanimate objects. They probably enshrine this boulder as a sacred object. Their tradition of worshipping such objects is similar to our tradition in Kurain. Interesting. Who knew Dirk could make sense every once in a while? Hey man, Dirk's great. He's just kind of shit at being a dad. You know. Hang on a minute. What do we have here? It looks like an unfinished picture. Like something a little kid might paint. You're right. But I can't quite tell what it's of. I think it's supposed to be nighttime. But what's that thing on the left? A monster or some kind of alien, perhaps? No, it's the man in the raincoat with the boulder. You silly knobs. In any case, it's a pretty poor excuse for a drawing. Well, what do you expect from a little kid? A little kid? Oh my god, yay! Oh, it's you, Pearl! Why, Mr. Apollo, is that you? What a pleasant surprise. It's been quite some time. How have you been? I say, yeah, she was quite prevalent in the last game, wasn't she? Yeah, I remember that. Fine, thanks. You're looking good too, Pearl. Aren't you going to introduce me, son? Of course. This is Pearl Fay. She's a spirit medium here in Kurain Village. Pearl, this is Dirk, my, client. Hello, sir. Pleased to meet you. If there's anything I can do to help, please let me know. Nice to meet you too. And what a polite little girl you are. Actually, I'm a high schooler. Whoops, sorry about that. So, you're a spirit medium. Does that mean you can channel spirits then? Yes, I'm still in training though. But I'm well versed in the art of spirit channeling. Well now, isn't that something? I mean, back in my country, our little princess hasn't channeled a single spirit yet. Pretty impressive, young lady. Oh, but compared to Mystic Maya, there is so much more I must learn. Mystic Maya? Oh right, Maya Fey, Mr. Wright's former courtroom assistant. He told me all about her. She's a spirit medium too, if memory serves. Yeah, she's an amazing medium, and soon she'll be the next head of the Fey clan too. Mediums and spirit channeling. I've heard all about it from Mr. Wright. Gosh, you must have seen it, surely. I swear at one point. Oh, he said that mediums will even physically become the person they're channeling, which led to very many awkward situations where Pearl had to channel, was it Mia? And yeah, that was weird. Where she was, I think she was like 8 in the first set of games, and she had to channel like a 30-year-old woman with massive tits. It was like, I wonder if even little Pearl would turn into a hulking giant if she had to channel one. I hope you don't mind me asking, but what brings you all the way out here, Mr. Apollo? Oh, just a small matter to take care of. Wait, would it happen to be the matter of Mr. Edgeworth? Fucking hell, everyone's getting in on it, aren't they? Crikey! Prosecutor Edgeworth? What's he doing here? Oh, so it's a different matter then. Because I just saw him a moment ago. He appeared to be searching for something. Oh? Hey! Mr. Edgeworth is a friend of Mr. Wright's and the district's chief prosecutor. Why would he be here in Corain? Fucking everyone's bloody Corain. Well, no point obsessing over it. Come to think of it, you live here in Corain Village, don't you, Pearl? Yes, I was born and raised here. This is perfect, Apollo. Let's ask the young lady if she knows where the doctor might have gone last night. I was thinking the exact same thing. Maybe I should show her what we found in the doctor's study. Well, you know what? Considering she has a painting of the fucking raincoat, let's fucking present that raincoat. Oh. Oh, okay. Fine then. Fuck off. He sent me off. I mean, you must be tired from all your investigating. Oh no, you don't have to do that. We'll be just fine, thank you. She's so polite, it's hard not to feel rude around her. Alright then, fuck the raincoat. Well, it was a good idea. Apparently I have to try and fucking segue into it another way. What a peaceful place. Ah, nothing beats mountain air. Many of the villages have left for the city, but I just love it here. Blue skies, lush forests, star-filled skies at night, and fireflies in the summer. Plus, the big, beautiful blue ocean is just beyond that mountain. The ocean? What do you say we go for a swim, son? Oh, I think I'll pass. Besides, I can't swim. Pearl? Corain Village is like the home of spirit mediums, right? Yes, and I'm part of a long line of mediums. I've never seen a channeling before, but is it possible to channel the spirit of anyone who's passed away? No, not just anyone. You must know their face and true name. Really? You can channel a spirit just by knowing their face and name? That's an amazing ability. It is, but it can only be learned by those with a gift occurring in certain bloodlines. And years of intense training. At present, Mystic Maya and I are the only ones in our village who can channel spirits. Looks like spirit mediums are highly valued here, much like they are back in Corain. Corain. I heard there used to be many more of us a long time ago, but now we are in very short supply. Most of the women nowadays don't want to stay, they want the thrill of the big city. Yeah, well, you guys aren't exactly close to any shopping malls or nightclubs out here. But what about you? Are you not interested in things like that? Who, me? Well, I wouldn't mind a new outfit or two, and well, oh, never mind. It's okay, Pearl. You are at that age, after all. Oh, yeah, let's ask about fucking Paul. Oh, we met this weirdo earlier named Paul Letitian. Do you know anything about him? Yes, he's been campaigning a lot around here lately. And the noise he's been making has become quite a problem. People are especially upset that he's campaigning at all hours of the night and day. Well, the local police should arrest him for disturbing the peace. Unfortunately, there's little they can do because the Letitian family is so powerful. Well, isn't he the proverbial pampered provincial prince? Fucking hell, man. He seems pretty intent on winning here in Karain. Is there some special reason why? I'm not sure, but I have an idea. The spirit mediums of Karain once held considerable sway in the political world. Judging by his slogan, maybe that's what he's after. Great, so he's just another politician seeking powerful connections. The ability to commune with the dead gives comfort to those anxious about the future. Tiny Karain has preserved its independence by the Queen's power of spirit channeling. It must play a similar role in this village. Yes, even today, many here revere those with spirit medium blood flowing in their veins. So basically, as Paul Letitian's benefactor goes, so goes the whole village. Who is this benefactor? Who could hold this much sway over Karain village?
Right, so I've got a presenter with shit. Okie dokie. What have we got? Go on then, let's try out the moss.
Pearl, do you have any idea where this moss might grow? That looks like Mitama moss. It grows on Mount Mitama and gives off a soft glow in the dark. Mount Mitama? See that mountain over there? That's Mount Mitama. And how would one get there? You can take a bus from that bus stop over there. May I ask why you are so interested in that moss? Well, Dr. Buff was supposed to give us something, but it seems he hid it somewhere last night. He did? Maybe that's why he, Pearl, do you know something that might help us? Well, sounds like I'd better find out what she knows. Pearl, do you have any idea where Dr. Buff might have gone last night? Well... about that. All I know is Dr. Buff was somewhere on Mount Mitama. Oh my god, why would you lie? Oh, I can even see the tail, it's one single sweat drop. My bracelet, it's reacting! What possible reason do you have to fucking lie, woman? Which means Pearl is hiding something from me. Zoom in.
Go then. Yeah, where is it? I saw it. Oh no, I did not apparently. Oh wait a minute, oh bollocks, I didn't mean to do that. Oh right, oh I see, okay. Sorry, I'm spazzing. My bad. Well, I could have sworn it was a sweat drop, but okay, it's something else then. Why can't I speed this up? Oh, there you go. No, I can't. Anyway, did I just miss it? I swear I saw it. Or am I going mad? Alright, I might be going mad. I might be on completely the wrong track. Alright. Or is it something to do with her eyes? I don't know. But yeah, that's true. You can fucking look at. Is it that?
Gotcha. Oh. Well, that was convenient. Well, you seem anxious around the topic of Mount Mitomo. I could tell because you'd rub your thumb over a splotch of dried paint as you said it. What the fuck has that got to do with anything? Oh, well, that nighttime painting is yours, isn't it? This is so embarrassing. As you saw, I'm not a very good artist. But that picture has nothing to do with Dr. Buff. I'm not so sure about that. In fact, I'm gonna guess that while you were out here painting last night, you actually saw the good doctor heading out to Mount Mitomo from the bus stop. No, I didn't see anything like that, I swear! No, I'm positive you saw the doctor. After all, he's right here in your picture. Take that. Fucking told you. You think that's the doctor? I may not be a very good artist, but at least I know how to draw a person. Okay, if this isn't a person, then what is it? That's a rain spirit! And what's a rain spirit doing at a bus stop? Oh, rain spirits have places to go to! This is getting ridiculous. Sorry, Pearl, but you're not a very good liar. That is Octobuff, and this piece of evidence fucking proves it. Thank you very much. So why didn't you want to say anything? This is the raincoat we found in the doctor's study. It's still wet and muddy, so we know that someone wore it last night. Now, see how this pattern is the same as the rain spirit in your picture? Ah, you didn't see a rain spirit last night. You saw Dr. Buff wearing this raincoat. Yes, well done. Jolly good show. I'm sorry. I know I'm not supposed to lie, but...
Cool, well, why would you lie? What possible reason would you have to lie? Other than to
add another gameplay gimmick in. I'm sorry I didn't tell you before, Mr. Apollo, but I did see the doctor last night. It's alright, just please tell me everything you know. Of course. I was painting out here last night when the doctor came up to the bus stop. He was wearing a raincoat, even though it wasn't raining, and a helmet with a light on it. Sounds like he was well prepared for something. I know, that's why I asked him if he was going off exploring again. He looked startled, like he hadn't noticed me there. And then, he suddenly said, "Please don't tell anyone you saw me here." Oh. Why would he want to silence you like that? Something must have happened to spook him. And he didn't want anyone to know where he was going to hide the orb. But where could he have been going dressed like that? My best guess is a cave somewhere on Mount Mitomo. I heard there's a cave there where mediums of the Karain tradition went to train long ago. Legend has it there is some sort of mystical ruins in there. Mystical ruins? Sounds like the exact sort of place an archaeologist might go. Well, we should get going now, but thanks for all your help, Pearl. You're welcome, Mr. Apollo. Please take care. What do you say we go find that cave, son? I sense that the orb might finally be within our grasp. This treasure hunt is shaping up to be the real deal. Ha ha ha! Really gets the blood pumping, doesn't it? Well, what are we waiting for? Let's go. Away! Oh, we just zoom in straight there. Phew, I'm all out of breath. Oh, come on, that was nothing! You're so much younger than me. Huff, puff. Don't normally get this much exercise. Cough, sputter. Need a break? No, I'm fine. Huff, puff. Doug, look! There's Mitomo moss growing in that cave over there. This must be where the doctor was last night. Let's take a look inside. Oh, it's moving along. There we are at 44 minutes. Yeah, fair enough. I can't see a thing. Relax, your eyes will adjust eventually. Now, follow me. I really think we need a flashlight, Dirk. Should have brought one along then, son. Here, use mine. Thanks! Wait, were you holding out on me? Who are you talking to, Apollo? You? Whoa! Someone just pushed me! Apollo? What the? Apollo! Ah!
Oh no. Ow. Are you alright, son?
Yeah. Looks like someone got the drop on us.
Quite literally.
But who? I mean, we could have died from that fall.
I don't know.
But I don't think we'll be getting out the way we came in. Looks like we're in a pretty deep cave. Nothing to do but to press on, son.
How can you even see in here?
Come on, let's go.
Hey, wait!
One false step and we're dead. What in the world should we do?
Alright, we've got climb back up. That's not happening. Go forward or wait here.
Go forward? I guess we keep going. There must have been some path for Dr. Buff to follow when he came to hide the orb.
Right, by the way, it looks like our attacker left us with this useful parting gift.
Huzzah!
From Lawyer to Spelunker, how do I always get myself into these situations? We're never going to make it out alive, I hope you know.
Don't tell me you're scared, son. We're just getting started. The greatest treasures are only ever found at the point of a blade, or the edge of a cliff.
Yeah, sure. If I'd known I'd wind up at the bottom of some dark, damp cave, I would have never taken your request, Dirk. Save your breath, Apollo. Just keep putting one foot ahead of the other.
There'd really better be a way out of here. We'll find one before you know it. You'll see.
12 hours later.
Huff, puff. We've been walking for over an hour. It's like amazing here. I couldn't get back to where we started if I wanted to.
Yeah. This cave goes deeper than I thought.
Wait, don't tell me there really is no way out.
Where there's a will, there's a way.
Ever the optimist, aren't you? Maybe we should cut our losses while we still can.
Fuck that. Forge ahead, bitch.
Even if we were to turn back, we wouldn't make it up that wall of solid rock. So I guess we keep going.
Sigh. How do I get stuck wandering around in a dark cave again?
It's definitely not in my job description.
Yeah, listen, son. Only the truly accomplished have the luxury of being so choosy. When I was just starting out, I did everything from street performing to yak milking.
And that helps you become an accomplished attorney, how?
It didn't, but when you need to earn a living, you'll take on any job just to survive.
Say, how is your career going, by the way?
Well, it's been a harrowing adventure so far, to say the least.
Oh shit, are we gonna go over his game?
Yeah. My first trial really put me through the ringer.
And my next case had me investigating a pair of stolen panties.
Good times. And just when I was hitting my stride, this one prosecutor branded me as Hair Forehead.
Oh, and there's this other ridiculous prosecutor who wields a samurai sword.
Sounds like you've, seen quite a bit.
You're telling me?
Listen, Apollo.
I'm sorry I didn't contact you for so long.
It's fine, Dirk. What happened, happened.
Hmm?
Careful, the ground doesn't feel as solid here.
What?
Oh balls! Yikes, the cave floor's collapsing!
Ah, not again!
Ah!
Oh dear!
These two zany funsters.
How are they gonna get out of this one?
Hey, Apollo, can you hear me?
Dirk?
Oh, shit.
Huh? Where are we? Whoa! What is this place? Oh. I was shocked too. These ruins look really old. It's not exactly something you'd expect to find in the middle of a cave system, that's for sure. Maybe the doctor hid the orb around here? I mean, those look like footprints over there. Son, I think our little adventure is about to pay dividends. Time to find that orb.
Seems like it'd be a little too convenient, but that's me.
Go on then, let's start with this shit. This box looks pretty new. I'm guessing the doctor's the one who brought it down here. It's no good. It's locked tight. There's no way to open it? Doesn't look like it. There isn't even a keyhole. Which means there must be some trick to opening it. We'll have to figure it out if we want to see what's inside.
That we will. Don't follow up on that though, game.
So that's the hole we fell through. Doesn't look like we'll be going back that way. We're lucky we survived the fall from way up there. Indeed, if that hole hadn't been above the lake, we'd be history.
You passed out the moment you hit the water.
Yeah, well, water's not really my thing.
This cavern is solid rock all around. Looks like we either go back through that hole, or find some other way out.
Ugh, why am I always between a rock and a hard place?
It's a big stone altar. One false move and some god might come and smite us.
Oh, come on, it's not all doom and gloom. I dare you to look at our surroundings and say that again, Dirk. Ha! You've got me there, son. Dear gods, please smite me now.
What's over there?
This lake looks really deep. I can't even see the bottom. A bottomless lake in the depths of a mountain cave system. My blood runs cold at the thought of falling in there. The water, it's salty. This lake may very well lead to the ocean. Didn't Pearl mention something about the ocean? Like how it's on the other side of the mountain? Can't imagine she meant it literally. What's a plastic bottle doing here? There's seaweed stuck to it, which means it probably came from the ocean. It's possible. Yes, thank you. Thank you. Well done.
Let's just, let's hammer that one home.
These have got to be the doctor's footprints. They match the bottoms of the boots we saw in his study. So he made it all the way down here. The water's washed most of them away, but his footprints are everywhere. Really? Because these are the only set I see. He must have been looking for something. Ah, those prints. They're coming out of that lake. Hey, you're right. But that would mean Dr. Buff came walking out of the water. Let's sum up what we know so far. The orb is almost definitely inside this box contraption that we can't open. As for this cave, there doesn't seem to be any way out. We're this close to the orb. Oh, come now, son. Don't be like that. It's just a bit of bad luck, that's all. A bit? Murthy called. He wants his law back. What doesn't kill you makes you stronger, right? How can he laugh at a time like this? We're stuck here for now, so you might as well try to open this thing. Okay, let's see what we're dealing with. Oh. This thing is covered with pictures, and hey, each section also rotates.
Cool.
Take a look at this, son. See the picture of a dragon battling a tiger? And this green and purple one is of a Kuranaese butterfly and a Metama. I wonder if they're clues for figuring out how to open this box.
Yeah, it'll be like the last fucking thing that I can't remember for the life of me. Because I know we had to do that to get open some shit.
There's a big button here. Huh, nothing happened. It appears this box uses a picture-based combination lock. We'll have to arrange the pictures on each side in the correct sequence. Well, you see, that's surprisingly shit. How many pictures were there? What, there were four? Was it five? Like, different sections? So, what, you have a... Oh, I can't remember how that fucking works. Is it five squared? So it's 25. There's 25 different combinations. Oh, wait, no. No, it's not that. Is it five cubed? I can't fucking remember. It's something like that. Well, it depends how many pictures there are, actually, doesn't it? Because if it's five, and then I couldn't tell, I couldn't be able to check what the shape was. Whatever, I was just saying, like, I would have thought you could do a little bit better than that. Because part of the reason why combination locks are so brutal is because you've got fucking 0 to 9 on it. Yeah, let's see, there's the dragon and tiger fight, a Kuranites butterfly with a Metama, and a number of other pictures too. Dirk, I was thinking, maybe we should check the evidence we've collected so far. I think we have something that just might help us open it. You read my mind, son! I think this will help us open the puzzle box.
It's that one, isn't it? Yep.
Dr. Buff's research notes mention the Song of Ceremony. Maybe its lyrics and the pictures on the box correspond somehow. I think you're onto something, son. Okay, let's give it a shot. Each dial has 6 pictures, and there are 4 dials in all. The box should open once the pictures are arranged in the right order. Funky puzzle box. Here comes justice!
Okay, right, no. So, when dragon and tiger battle... Right, so we want fucking dragon first. When the butterfly embraces the Metama. So we want that butterfly, yo. Offer thy prayers as fervent as fire, only then shall the Holy Mother return.
I think it's that one. Sorry, I ain't got a particularly brilliant view of this.
Descending upon us all in her glory, the founders bestow the greatest power known. The founder bestows the greatest power known. Okay, right. So I think it actually might be that one there. Was it offer prayers? Is it that one?
Nope.
Pictures aren't in the right order. The gate should open if the pictures are arranged properly, but I know, I should carefully consider which part of the song corresponds to which picture.
Well, it's kind of tricky, they're a little bit vague in certain respects.
Alright, where's fucking prayer then? Well, is it, offer thy prayers as fervent as fire. Only then shall the Holy Mother return.
Is it that one? I think so. We'll rock and roll with that. Nope. Thank you. Thank you!
When the butterfly, offer thy prayers as fervent as fire, only then shall the Holy Mother return. Singing upon us all in her glory, the founder bestows the greatest power known. Alright then, well it says the Holy Mother returns, so... Are we rocking with that? No?
Well, I'm 97% confident this bit's fine.
When dragon and tiger battle, the founder offers divine protection.
I I don't know, they're battling and there's someone offering some shite.
Founder offers divine protection when the butterfly, yeah, got that.
Unless you can have the same picture twice, but I don't see why you would. I'm trying to think if I'm rocking with the second line of everything. It could be.
The favour of the orb is bestowed. Is there even fucking a thing for that? I think it is. No, I think it's got to be that.
I think the top two are fucking right.
Offer thy prayers as fervent as fire, only then shall the Holy Mother return.
Well, I'm sorry, but what's that? That's just, I don't know, she's breathing smoke towards a tiger of some description. I don't fucking know.
That's a dragon noshing.
I'm convinced the last one's right as well. I think it's just the third one that I'm not sure about.
Because I don't know what the fucking...
I mean, there's only bloody two with the Holy Mother in it. You got that one. You got that one.
Fuck it, what do you have to say?
This is harder than I imagined. I thought all we had to do was to arrange the pictures according to the song. It's times like these you have to think outside the puzzle box. Sometimes the truth can only be found when you look at things from a different angle. A different angle? Come to think of it, one of the pictures from the song is miss... Well, you know what?
Fuck you.
Does this mean the pictures don't line up exactly one to one? Hey?
Oh, wait, so is it that? Because, I mean, that's just an thing. Descending upon us in all our glory, the Founder bestows the greatest power known. I'm convinced that's the last one. Butterfly's definitely second. Dragon and Tiger, the Founder offers divine protection. Unless is it like that? No. Well, I haven't got the foggiest fucking idea. Oh, hang on a fucking minute. Oh, I suddenly understand now. I'm a fucking pleb. Right, terribly sorry. Alright, well that's fucking fine. That's also fine. Oh, you saucy pig fuckers. Got ya on board. Got ya with it. Boosh. Got ya. Lovely. Sorry, I'm a pleb. Oh. It opened. So this is the Founder's Orb. We did it, son! The orb is finally ours! Cool. At last, the Founder's Orb is ours. And it's all thanks to you, son. Well done.
Then again, I'd expect nothing less from my boy. Oh, it's no big deal. Don't sell yourself short. You may think it's nothing, but your insights and reasoning led us here. And I'd say that's truly impressive. I don't know about that. After all those battles you fought in the courtroom, have shaped you into the man you are today, and I couldn't be prouder. But will you cut it out already, before I turn into a sun-ripened tomato? With this orb, I can finally deliver a fatal blow to the Garan regime. Ha! So, how exactly do you plan on using it? You're not going to try to become a spirit medium, are you? Don't be ridiculous, I don't need supernatural powers like that. So then, are you going to use it as a bargaining chip with Queen Garan? Like demanding she abolishes the Defense Culpability Act? Well, the thought had crossed my mind, but the main thing is returning this to the Kingdom of Karain. After all, as a sacred relic of Karainism, that is where it belongs. Really? That's all you wanted to do? Mm-hmm. Because my true objective has always been to find out who asked Dr. Buff to study it and why. I'm not sure I follow. The official story is that the orb was stolen from the Temple treasure room. Yeah, I heard about that on the news. They also said your group was behind the theft. That's not good. We're probably on an international most wanted list now. Let me ask you something, Apollo. Who do you think really stole the orb? I really haven't a clue. Well, I think it was one of the royals. Really? Someone from the royal family? Yeah, and I've got a pretty good idea which one it was. Could it be the shady man that no one fucking likes and is generally distrustful of? Hmm? Could it be him? He knows who it is. Care to share your hunch? All I'll say at this point is this. Security is pretty tight, but the royals have unfettered access to the treasure room. Plus, they seem to be turning a blind eye to the orb's loss. But why would a member of the royal family do that? That I haven't figured out yet. But whatever the reason, it can't be good. I mean, a Karainese royal stealing a national treasure of such religious significance? And then pinning the crime on us, the Defiant Dragons? Sounds like a conspiracy or something. I agree. And if the truth were to come to light, it would be a scandal of epic proportions. To allow a foreign national to study a treasure so sacred that it's off-limits to the public, it would be seen as an utter sacrilege to those who truly revere the Holy Mother. So if this were to go public, support for the Garan regime would weaken. But that's not all. This is just a hunch. But I believe there's something even bigger here. Something that would explain why the orb was being studied in the first place. Something that would shake the Kingdom of Karain to its very core. And I'm gonna find out what. He's probably right. His intuition is usually spot on. Dirk, why are you so bent on revolution anyway? Is it to reform the legal system in Karain? There's that. But I'm also doing this for my children. I want to save Nayuta. What do you mean? This is for your ears only. It's the other reason why this revolution needs to succeed. Nayuta, I never thought that our reunion would take place in a courtroom. Oh, so you've run into each other already. Yeah, but it was like he was a different person. He used to be such a kind, cheerful kid, always smiling and stuff, but now... He tried to convict Trucy for a crime she didn't even commit. Plus, he kept telling me I had a putrid mind and to let it go and move on. Has it really gotten that bad? It must be Karan's influence. He wasn't like that when he first stepped into the courtroom. Back then, he still had a keen sense of justice. I vow to bring the Karan regime down and reform the legal system. That's what he swore to do. But that was also 5 years ago. He'd been the shining star of the Defiant Dragons, and our greatest hope. Wait, Nayuta was a dragon? He was. But these days, he's more like Garan's lapdog. Talk about a complete about face. Why would he do that? Something must have happened to him. Something that sparked a radical change. Still, I don't think he truly believes in the new path he's taken. It's not conviction that fills his heart. It's resignation and despair. I see. The only thing I know for sure is Nayuta is suffering, and he is suffering in silence. Nayuta is suffering? Yes. He knows the rightful state of Karan's legal system. But something forces him to bend to Karan's will, and it's tearing him apart. But it's been 5 years. Do you really think he even still wants to reform the legal system? As long as he carries what I've taught him in his heart, I do. Crikey Moses, that got a bit, melodramatic, didn't it? Doug's teachings. A dragon never yields. That's what you always told us. That I did. It's a belief I've held since back when I was a lawyer. The dragon stands at the pinnacle of the natural world. Nothing and no one can bend its will. That's why we lawyers must pursue the truth like an unyielding dragon, right? We must fight for truth to the bitter end, no matter what it takes. Dirk and Mr. Wright, they have that much in common. That's why I've held onto this badge, even though there are no more lawyers in Karain. I believe that one day our legal system will return to its former glory, and this badge here is a testament to that belief. I wonder if Nayuta still believes in what you taught us. He does, that much I'm sure of.
A dragon never yields.
I know that belief is etched deep in his heart. I'd bet my life on it. After all, he is my flesh and blood! This unshakable faith and confidence. It's what draws people to him, whether they like it or not. Even people like me. You know, I remember back when we were kids, Nayuta used to say with great pride, I have the blood of the dragon within me. Yes, and that's why I want to free him. Free him from the poisonous clutches of the Garan regime. So that's your other reason for starting a revolution. Yes, I need to smack some sense into that boy of mine. I mean, what else are fathers for? I wouldn't know. Now that we have the orb, on to the next problem. Getting out of here. Well, we're not going back the way we came, that's for sure. That hole we fell through is way too high to climb back up to. Naturally, I have an idea. That lake water tastes salty, which means it must connect to the ocean. Wait a second. You're not suggesting we swim our way out of here. That's exactly what I'm suggesting. But we have no idea how deep that lake goes. It's pitch black down there. Not a problem. How is that not a problem? I mean, how do you even know if there's really a passage to the ocean? Well, one of us has to try, and I'm the better swimmer. Time's a-wasting. I'll be back before you know it, son. Oh, balls. Dirk! He's gone. I sure hope he knows what he's doing. It's been 20 minutes. I hope he's okay. Oh, balls. What's going on? Uh-oh. The water! It's rising! And fast! Ah! Need air! Cough, sputter, cough, cough. Ah! I don't know how to swim! If I don't grab onto something that floats. Go for the log, dipshit. Cough, sputter, cough, cough. This is bad. I better think of something. Quick!
Go for the fucking log, you bellend!
I've got it! As long as I hold onto this, I should be able to stay afloat. This is not good. The water's almost up to the top of the altar. It won't be long before it reaches the roof of the cave. The puzzle box is still at the base of the altar. It must have been designed to stay put, even at high tide. Wait, that's it! Dr. Puff must have gotten in here from some oceanside entrance at low tide. That's why his footprints were leading out of the lake. So it really does connect to the ocean. Not that that helps, I drowned before I made it out. Hey, maybe I can use this like an oxygen tank. Wait, what am I thinking? I need to stay calm and be more rational about this. I don't fucking know. Why don't you shoot for the hole, dipshit? It's no use, the hole's still too high up. I'll have to find another way, and quick, before I drown. Where's that? You're the log, you dumbass! The water won't stop rising! Ah, I'm getting swept away! Ah, please! Stop! Yeah, so now you can go for the fucking hole, can't you? The water's just high enough for me to reach the hole! I'm saved! All I have to do is go back the way we came. The water might even lift me all the way back up over that wall of rock. Here goes! Huh? The hole! It's full of rubble! The tunnel collapsing above must have filled it in after we fell through it. Yeah, this can't be happening! No, I can't give up now. I refuse to die here! The water! I can't! Cough, sputter. I can't. I can't breathe. Oh dear. Is this the end? Dirk. I wonder if he made it out. So this is what it feels like to drown. I would have eaten that sushi if I'd known it would be my last meal. I feel like I've been through this before. Ah, now I remember. It was back when all three of us were living in that shack in the mountains. Nayuta and I were playing by the riverside when we got swept up in the rapids. I thought we were goners, but then... Nayuta! Apollo! Hold on, I'm coming! Sniffle, sniffle, sniffle. Wah! Wah! Ha, 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 ha. That was a close one. Thought I'd lost you two. I'm sorry, Dirk. All right, that's enough now. Didn't I teach you that boys don't cry? Thank you, Father. Sniffle, hiccup, hiccup. You could have been killed, but you risked your life to save us. Why? What a silly question. What father wouldn't risk his life to save his own children? Nayuta, Apollo, don't you ever hesitate to call when you need me, understand? Hey Dirk, this isn't forever, right? You'll bring me back from America someday, right? Of course. I'll come pick you up as soon as things settle down here. Promise. Okay, you promised.
Dirk. I waited and waited for the day you'd come and take me home. But you never came. What a prick. And that's why I tried to forget about you. And my life back in Karain. Dirk. Why? Why didn't you? God, this drowning's taking a while, isn't it? Apollo, can you hear me? Cough, sputter, cough. Dirk? Still can't swim, eh? You came back? But why? I said I'd come for you, didn't I? Yeah, but you can't hold me and swim. We're both going to. Stop talking. You'll bite your tongue. What? Whoa, whoa, whoa! We're being pulled under! What's going on? Why is this happening? Well. Cough. Where? Ah, you finally came too, son. Get your fill of seawater? Good thing your name's not Neptune, huh? Dirk. You're telling me? Check it out! Snot's coming out of his nose! What a miraculous escape! Not even some of the escape artist greats could pull that off. What on earth happened? Sorry it took me so long, son. I made it to the ocean, but I figured you still couldn't swim. So I found a local fisherman and had him take us out near the undersea cavern. He tied a rope to me, and I came and grabbed you, then he yanked me back. Oh, so that's what pulled us under with such force. Don't forget about me, I assisted in your escape back too, Polly. I've helped compatriots escape from all sorts of places. Mountain jails, island prisons. But an undersea cavern? Now that was a first. Dirk. He risked his life for me. Dirk, I'm only alive because of you. Thank you. You're welcome. I just did what any father would do for his son. He saved my life yet again. Growl. I guess seawater doesn't make for much of a meal. It's because Polly didn't have any sushi. Oh yeah, I haven't eaten anything since this morning. Oh, that's right. Hey, AJ! Dirk had me buy this for you. Thought you might be hungry. Ready to have some this time around? Yeah, thanks. Chomp, nom, nom, nom. Oh, wow, this is delicious. Ha, 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 ha. Glad you approve. I'd better get some before you eat them all. Chomp, chew, chew, chew. Just like old times. Yeah, almost dying. Dirk used to slice up the fish he caught and we'd all eat fresh sashimi together. He used to talk about all the vitamins and minerals packed in the raw fish. Chomp, munch, munch, munch. Hey, by the way, let me see that orb, AJ. There you go. Whoa, so that's what it looks like. You found the legendary treasure? Nice work, Polly. Thanks. Guess you could say mission accomplished. With the orb, our revolution can take a big step forward. Let's celebrate the eve of our revolution. We'll get all dressed up and feast till dawn. Yeah! Now you're talking. Time to party. After all that, I just want to go to bed. Sure wish Nayuta was here. Maybe one day we'll enjoy times like these together again. Their evolution, if it can bring back those happy days.
you can sign me up for. Sorry to interrupt your little party, but I'm here for my crystal. Right, left, halt! Ah, it's him again! Heh heh heh. Well done. Then again, I always knew you could do it. After all, we politicians must be excellent judges of character. Still, I'm impressed you both made it out of there alive. Wait a second. You're the one who shoved us into that pit? It sounds so bad when you say it like that. All I did was give you a little nudge in the right direction. So, it was you. Oh shit! You no good son of a... Eep! Don't look at me like that! The crystal of Amifei is mine, now hand it over! Over my dead body! Eek! Detective, help! Oh, hello. Yeah, I know. Emma, what's going on here? He filed a police report. He claims you're trying to steal his family heirloom. That's him! The one with the long hair! Arrest him this instant! He's the thief that made off with the Atishan family's most precious heirloom! Well, I suppose I should ask you to come in for questioning. Down at the police station? I think I'll pass. After all, Mr. Atishan seems bent on having me arrested on theft charges. This is not good. If Dirk gets arrested, he'll be sent back to Karain to face execution. Sorry, but now that I know you have the crystal, or orb as you call it, I must insist. Will you please come with me, sir?
Hold it.
Oh, hang on. Emma! I'm afraid I can't let you take Dirk in. He received the orb from Dr. Buff in a perfectly legal transaction.
Is that so? Can you prove it? Of course. This should sufficiently prove that the orb now belongs to Dirk.
Take that!
Take a look at this agreement. What do we have here? Let's see. I agree to hand over the Founder's Orb to the Defiant Dragons if I will come to no harm. It appears to be a perfectly legal agreement. Not so fast! That's not the Founder's Orb! It's the crystal of Amifei, which means their agreement is null and void. This is going nowhere fast. You can say that again. Then it will just have to go to trial. Right, Apollo? Hey! Mr. Wright? Daddy! What's with you two? You look like you just saw a ghost. Oh yeah. Emma mentioned she had seen him around. What are you doing in Karain Village, Mr. Wright? Mr. Atishan has retained me as his lawyer. What? Wait, you're his lawyer? Fuck off! Mr. Wright, why are you serving as Mr. Atishan's lawyer? Because he hired me. He needed my help in getting a family heirloom back from Dr. Buff. And it seems he correctly foresaw that something like this might happen. It's because those shifty insurgents were harassing poor- What the fuck, man?
Everyone's so racist. Oh, dear.
So I knew I might need a lawyer if things went south. I figured with a celebrated lawyer like Phoenix Wright, I couldn't go wrong. Is this what you came back from Karain for, Mr. Wright? It was just good timing. My work over there just happened to wrap up, so here I am. Plus, Mr. Atishan is a very important client. They know each other? But I've never heard Mr. Wright mention his name before. Mr. Wright, are you sure this is Mr. Atishan's family heirloom? That's my client's assertion. He says it's the crystal of Amifei. Apparently, it's the crystal she once used when channeling spirits. Who's Amifei? She brought Karanae's channeling to Japan, and her descendants brought it here. Her true origins are still rather murky, but what's clear is she is the founder of the Karain channeling technique. Oh, so she's like the one they call the founder in Karai and the Holy Mother. Apollo, I don't plan to betray my client's confidence. I may not know all the facts yet, but I do know we won't be handing the crystal over to you. What? Are you saying... I'm really sorry it's come to this, but... Mr. Wright, I don't understand. Let me spell it out then. If you continue to claim that the crystal belongs to your client, then I will be seeing you in court. Oh my god! What? What's gone into you, Daddy? Nothing. This is strictly business. Heh heh heh. Two lies from the same firm facing off? What are the odds? Lucky for me, I believe I have the right man for the job. Whatever are you going to do? Remember, he is your boss. Yeah. How did it come to this? But Mr. Wright, please, don't do this! Apollo, there's no point in arguing about it here. When it's now clear, we're headed to court. That's where we'll find out who the crystal really belongs to. I don't believe it. Am I really gonna face Mr. Wright in court? Daddy! Apollo! No! We can't have our agency's talent competing against each other! It's too late, Trucy. The die has been cast. We each have to fight for our client's best interest. But... So, what's it gonna be, Apollo? Are we gonna have to take this to trial? Fuck yes! I have to battle Mr. Wright in court? The legendary Phoenix Wright? No matter how many trials of his I've watched. No matter how dire the situation, he's always pulled out a win in the end. Can I do it? Can I really take on the man whose footsteps I've been following in? I owe it to Dirk to at least try. What should I do? Fuck yeah, Battle Business! This is the coolest thing in the world! There's no turning back now. If it's a trial you want, Mr. Wright, I'm more than happy to oblige. I'm ready to fight for my client, even if it means facing off against you. Alright. I won't be pulling any punches either, Apollo. The kid gloves are officially off. May the best attorney win. You got it. Whoa! First Daddy, now you? Polly, you're not seriously. Sorry, Trucy, but I have to do this. Apollo. Alright then, I'd better go prepare for tomorrow. See you in court. Oh yeah, buddy! Daddy, no, wait! A fine mess I've gotten you into, son. I mean, of all the lawyers we could have faced, it had to be him? He's practically a celebrity in Karai now. They're calling him the Fighting Phoenix. I'll be fine! After all, I've come a long way too. Who knows, I could even end up winning. There's always a chance, right? You know, this may be a blessing in disguise. If the trial proves what we found is indeed the Founder's Orb, then whoever asked Dr. Buff to study it may be revealed too. This is our chance to finally pull them out of the shadows! The first step of your revolution, huh? Yes, a revolution to restore Karai into its former glory and save Nyuta's soul! Dirk, I swear to fight as hard as I can in court to make that a reality. We're going to win this one, you'll see. I know you can do it, son. Oh, shit! It doesn't matter that I'll be going up against Mr. Wright. I have to win this for Dirk. And for Nyuta. His salvation, along with all of Karain, depends on it. Yeah, no fucking pressure. Alright, that's the fucking, like, coolest fucking thing fucking ever. Shit, man, that was awesome.
That was epic! Oh, fucking hell, I'm playing this shit all night! That's awesome! I'm fucking in love with that. Unfortunately, I have to go do shopping and things, because I need food. But when I come back, and when I have eaten... Oh, man. That was fucking great! I never, ever expected that would happen. And now there's loads of fucking intrigue. Oh, fucking Edgy was in it. Pearl showed up. Where's Maya gone? Did Maya, is Maya done? If Maya's fucking done, I'll be really annoyed. Because it's like, give her a bit more than like 10 minutes. Christ. I'm assuming she'll be in the last episode. Because let's face it, they basically just said there's going to be an episode 6. Which is sweet. I'm down for that. But yeah. So next time that's fucking happening, I hope you've all enjoyed. I wasn't fucking expecting that. I think the only problem was that last bit got a bit fucking railroady, but it was cool. It had lots of interesting exposition and shit about Apollo. So yeah, it was great. All right, I'll see you for the next part then in a bit. Peace.